To construct a scatter diagram or scatter plot in Excel, make sure the independent or X variable is to the left of the Y variable. Then select the entire data. You can select labels if you like. Click Insert. Click the scatter charts here and select the first one. And here we have the scatter diagram. I'm going to right-click on one of the dots and select Add Trend Line. I'm going to check Display Equation and Display R-squared. I'm going to move them up here and increase their size by clicking this icon here. I'm going to click the plus button to the right here and select Axis Titles. Type X for the X-axis and Y for the Y-axis. Then click on the chart title here and name it Scatterplot. You can see that we have a positive relationship here as the trend line moves up from left to right, or because the slope of the line 0.4504 here is positive. The R-squared value tells us that about 76.6% of the variation in Y is explained by the variation in X. We can also estimate the residual values from the graph. Residual is simply actual Y value minus the predicted Y value estimated by the regression line. For example, at X equals 23, the actual Y value is 20, while the predicted Y value is about 15. The residual at X equals 23 is therefore 20 minus 15, which is 5. At X equals 34, the residual is approximately 0 since the actual point coincides with the line here. Let's look at another example. I'm going to select the data without the labels this time. Click Insert, then Scatter. I'm going to right-click on one of the dots and add Trend Line, Display Equation and R-squared. And as you can see, we have a negative relationship here. The line slopes downwards from left to right, and the value of the slope here is negative. At X equals 27, we have a residual of about 0. And at X equals 30, we have a residual of about minus 10. The actual value is 10, and the predicted value is 20. So 10 minus 20 gives us negative 10. Let's look at one more example. Highlight the data, insert, scatter. In this case, the points are located far from the origin, and I would like them to be more spread out. Observe that all the points are above 60 on the y-axis. So I can double-click on the y-axis values here, click the histogram icon to the right here, then enter 60 for the minimum value. Note also that all the points are above 30 on the x-axis. So I can double-click on the x-axis as well and change the minimum value to 30. The points now fill the chart. In cases like this, it's important to indicate that the axes do not start at 0. And that's it. Thanks for watching.